Hi, my name is Sumrit Shahi and you're watching me on Cinespeaks.
Cinespeaks में आपका स्वागत है. Welcome to our channel. My first question being, your first novel, which you have written when you were 17, that young, which was just friends. Yes. What was your thought process?
It's a very interesting story actually. So I was in hostel in boarding and I got kicked out because you know, you do things at 17 which you shouldn't
sure.
be doing. Let me just say the hostel was in the hills, so there was a lot of green stuff available. So I got kicked out and I didn't have a, and I'm smiling right now, but it was a very bad time actually. So I came back home and I didn't have a school to go to that year. And I'm from Chandigarh, and you know how those Punjabi relatives and family friends are, like they would come in and like my parents were just disappointed. And they wouldn't say anything to me, but that disappointment in their eyes was just, it was irritating and torturous and fair enough, right? So I decided I had to do something with my life. I thought, let me just go ahead and write a book because I had nothing to lose. I didn't have a school to go to and a lot of time to kill. So yeah, I started writing a book. I used to write in the nights. My parents still thought that, you know, I'm completely off the plot and kuch to galat chal raha hai. I actually bumped school twice or thrice to go to Delhi. I took the Shatabdi and got like the publisher's contract eventually through that, because I used to meet publishers and stuff at that time. And yeah, the book just happened. Yeah, I think it came from a place of pure passion and genuine, honest will to prove something. So I think that's why like Just Friends happened. And I had thought 10 copies bhi bik gayi bahut hai, and it became a bestseller. And
exactly. Like, did you think people will like it that much?
Yeah, I wanted my parents to just feel that I'm doing something productive in life, and I thought I've got a decent book out there. But now that I read it, obviously, like, I could change so many things. But bestseller, I had no idea.
And one thing is for sure, whatever you write becomes a masterpiece, a piece of art.
Piece of art, such heavy words. Yeah.
No, actually, it becomes the top-notch one of that era. But then again, it comes with a lot of expectations every time you write. How do you cope up with that?
Oh, you have no idea, especially with like Never Kiss Your Best Friend, the web series that has just come out on my book releasing. Super expectations. And I think, you know, what works is I also have a set of friends that are genuine assholes. Like, they know how to put you in place, and sure, your support system is supposed to be very strong. So they keep me in check. They tell me, don't have expectations because you're not great anyway.
Yeah.
So I think you only have expectations when you think you're like out of the world. So yeah, that way
that is for sure. Friends always keep you grounded.
Yeah. I think one should always have friends who are assholes to you, otherwise you're not friends.
So how do you get the inspiration to write such good books?
Good or bad, I don't know. But like the inspiration comes from, let me politically correct first and tell you, you should read a lot. I think reading really opens your mind up. And don't only read genres that you like, just read. Most and importantly after that also travel. Yeah, like I think traveling, and like I make it a point every year to travel somewhere in the country and abroad, and I think that's super important to travel. And travel, don't just go and enjoy like sights and click pictures for the gram and come back. Meet people, interact, because experience in travel really really opens your mind up. But most importantly, I'm the type of writer who's lurking in the corner in the coffee shop and is overhearing your conversations, because I think there's nothing better than unfiltered real data available in front of you.
Now that you've said it, you listen to people's conversation and then you get your inspiration.
Yeah.
Do you have a real life acquaintance of you who you've made as a character in one
I
of
have, and I shall not name who that character is because that friendship is hanging by the thread already.
Cool. Then, do you have a role model as such?
A role model in life? I think I really look up to my mother, and purely, I know it's a very cheesy answer to give, but purely because she's really sacrificed a lot, A, and B, she's been really, really cool with me and my upbringing, in the sense that she's given me the freedom all along, so I've become responsible in life. Like, I come from a family, a traditional business Punjabi family, where they could have asked me to take care of the business, but they're letting me do what I do, which is amazing. So yeah.
You've got to know that you're going to Jaipur Literary Festival, and
yes,
you're one of the panelists. How did you feel when you heard the news?
It was surreal. I'll tell you what, I was in Symbiosis in Pune, and we used to go to JLF every year as students. And today, like cut to what, 4 years later, you're going there as a panelist. It's a crazy feeling. I've done Lit Fests before, but Jaipur is like the real deal. So,
and when you go for such festivals or events, do you do any preparations as a writer?
No, yeah, I think the whole idea of a festival like this, it is about engaging dialogue and having conversations. So if you prepare and go, you're not being real to yourself. So what's the point of doing that?
When you write such good things and then you get to know that those are becoming into a web series or a serial, do you think the director would ruin the part as the writer that you wrote?
I think it's very important, see, because I'll be very honest, it is difficult to let go of your vision, but it is also incorrect to not let anyone else interpret your vision. So a director is a director for a reason. Luckily for me, on the last series, Never Kiss, the director RF Khan and myself, we've had a lot of disagreements, but they were all for a good cause, and eventually I think it's important to reach a common place, because in creativity no one's right or wrong. So yeah, I mean, dard hota hai, but band-aids are available.
And whenever you write such things, what is the thought process that you give every time, something new?
The thought process is, I think the idea is to pick up topics that are relevant, that
are relatable
to people, and most importantly, through them just try to introduce a new thought or a new dialogue. I mean, it's not just fluff. Like, the genre that I write in is basically related to young people, so it's their feelings, it's romance, friendship, betrayal, other emotions like finding careers, and you know, you're dealing with your parents. But it's important to bring in a new mindset. Like with Never Kiss also, we dealt with LGBT, but we dealt it in a very sensitive way. The idea is to just bring dialogue, because the little change that you can make with your words, why not? Yeah.
Sure. And when you write, which is a favorite genre of yours you prefer writing on?
So I've mostly been writing relationship stories, but there's a thriller that I've just worked on, and I'm in talks with one of the OTT platforms where it's going to come out. So I'm really excited about that, because I also want to explore. So yeah, I mean, I'm very comfortable and happy writing relationship, but yes, the world is a canvas paint correctly.
And when it comes to reading, which is your favorite book that you've read, and which book would you suggest our viewers to read?
I'll suggest the viewers to read anything that they want. Do not go with my choice. Just read. Go and pick up any book that you want. Just start reading. Read simple books, difficult books, books you like, don't like. Just read. I mean, the world is not reading enough anymore. Yeah. I personally stopped reading because there's so many distractions. Instagram band kar dena chahiye.
And from the pieces that you've written, which one is your favorite?
Let's put it this way, which is the one that I hate the least, because the day I start liking my work, I'll get comfortable, right? So obviously, like, and you know, like, you also evolve with age. So of the three books that I've written, the first one I wrote when I was 17, which is like, okay, I'm not telling you my age, I'm very young, which is like 3 years ago. So 3 years ago, and you know, you evolve. So the least hated book is Never Kiss, for that matter, because it's, but Just Friends will always be special, because it was like my
very
first book, or my pehla bachcha mera, basically.
And do you have anything to say to our very young writers?
Yes. Most importantly, write because you want to write, not because you want to get famous. I'll be very honest. Because I've done the mistake myself. Take it from me. The first book came out because I wanted to write. Did really well. Second book, I thought, oh, I can just write anything. And that happened. And the book's popular, but I'm not very proud of it. So write because you want to write. Read a lot. And yeah, I mean, go ahead and publish, yeah. But don't write very well also, and I don't want competition in the market.
And in the world of social media, this is the last question. In the world of social media, there are very less people who prefer writing or reading, to be honest. What would you like to say to people to let them read, to encourage them to read?
I think that's a very valid and interesting question. Social media is a distraction. So even if you want to read articles, na, like, you know, or read books on the phone while you're browsing, you know, your social media apps, because we have so many audiobooks available now. There are so many PDFs and books that can be downloaded. So yeah, do that, yeah, because it's important to read. And I'm saying this as someone who's also like kind of not stopped, but has really reduced his reading, which isn't a good thing. 2020 resolution number one, read a book every day.
Okay, thank you.